And then
the fourth prayer, he said, that your hand would be with me.
That
your hand would be with me.
Isanda sako sibe nami.
Jabez made this wonderful prayer again.
He
prayed for the hand of God to be upon him.
And
what is the meaning of this?
Jabez
was saying, God, may your presence be with me.
When he
talks about the presence of God, what is it that Jabez is talking about?
Jabez
was saying, God, may your Holy Spirit be upon me. God, may your power be upon me.
He
was saying, God, as you are enlarging my territory, blessing me abundantly,
I don't
want to be alone. I want to enjoy these blessings with you.
Wherever I go with
my blessings, people, they must see my blessings and you also.
People,
if God is to bless you, you must pray for the presence of God to be upon you. As God is enlarging your territory, you need the Holy Spirit of God to be upon you.
You need the power of God to be upon
you. You
see,
make it without the Spirit of God inside of you. Let me tell you the truth. On your own, you are limited. You can do things on your own, but I'm telling you, you'll never do it for a long time. You can start full of energy, but you'll get tired very soon. You can start full of energy, but you'll get tired very soon.
You'll
have all the energy to travel wherever you want to travel. Without God, you'll get tired.
Some other areas you will not
even conquer.
Other
areas, I'm telling you, you will fail.
But when
you pray for the hand of God to be upon you,
you are saying,
God, your presence must walk with me.
When I'm
seated, when I'm eating, when I'm sleeping, I just want to feel your presence in me.
Everything
that I do, God, I want your Spirit to be there with me, helping out, guiding me, teaching me, showing me the way.
This
man was clever, eh? Yes, he was clever. He said, God, your hand must be with
me.
Church, don't walk without
God. You will
fail. At your workplace, don't work without God.
They will
blame you on each and everything, will fire you, and you won't understand as to why.
At your studies,
be with God.
So that you will never fail. I know
people who will pray like this, and then God will bless you. Then I've seen many people, the moment God bless them with tenders or with jobs,
then they fly. Because they feel they don't need God anymore.
And I've seen
many of them failing along the way.
And as they start to fail, they come back to
church.
Don't be foolish, Christians.
The presence
of God must be with you wherever you
are.
The man Moses, he saw this. Moses, he prayed, he said to God when he was on Mount Sinai,
he said,
if your presence is not going with us,
we are not going nowhere.
We are not moving forward. We are not going to enter that land. Moses was very much fully aware that he needed God to guide him to the land of promise. He needed God because of the people he was traveling with. He
Ngoba bekazi ukuthi abantu abahamba naye uma bengeke naye uNkulunkulu bazofuna inkazimulo kaNkulunkulu ukuthi ihambe nawe ukuze
bazofuna
uNkulunkulu masiyezweni
lesi
abantu fanele babone umehluko
ngenxa
yenkazimulo yakho ezabe
isebenzile
ngenxa yobukhona bakho buzobe
bunathi
ngenxa yobukhosi bakho buzobe bunathi yilokho ujebezi bekacalela ukulunga kwankulunkulu fanele kube khona
kini
ngakho ke siyawudinga ubukhona bukankulunkulu umoya wokwenza okuhle fanele kube ngaphezu
kwakudinga
umoya kankulunkulu ukwenza konke ngiyakutshela ngeke uphumelele ngaphandle
kwankulunkulungeke
uze unqobe ngaphandle
kwankulunkulukuphumelela
kutholakala kuye kuphela ukunqoba kutholakala kuphela egameni likajesu bandla khuleka ukuthi ubukhona bakho bube nami
God must cover you by his glory.
UNkulunkulu akwembeze ngenkazimulo
yakhe. In the interview room when they look at you they must see and see that this one does not look like other. There is something different with this one. Something shining, something amazing, something unimaginable. That is the glory of God traveling with you.
Mawuhamba ke nenkazimulo kaNkulunkulu ngisho la ku interview room so ungenile phakathi mabekubheka bazobona ukuthi lo akafani nabanye khona ukukhazimulo okuthile kuye.
Even the sources when they meet you in the dark place, they cannot grab you.
Now what sources are they standing there? When they meet, they are going to be
bound. This one, they'll just stand and let you pass by. The next one will be the victim.
Bazo manje bakubekudlule bese omunye bambaba.
So if they grab you one day, you were traveling alone. You were not with you with that God.
Mangabe bakubambeke uhamba uwedwa kusho ukuthi bowunganayo uNkulunkulu
mhlawumbe
ushiye uNkulunkulu wakho kuphi kuphi
stay in the house and then allow me to walk alone that's why they grab you and they'll take your cell phones
yingakho ke uzothi uhamba ngesinye isikhathi ushiye uNkulunkulu ngoba mhlawumbe unamahloni ngaye bawuhamba bakuthathele
I'm just making a point.
Angikhulumi noma ngobani la ngenza nje iphuzu.
Some of you it happened because things do happen to each and every one.
Abanye izinto kimi zenzeke ngoba nakubani izinto zenzeke.
But there are others who said no I don't need the presence of God I will do it on my own and then bam.
Bese kukhona ke abanye abasho ukuthi akudingi ubukhona bukaNkulunkulu bese kuyenzeka. Bandla nakudinga ubukhona bukaNkulunkulu.
Indlu
yakho iyakudinga ubukhona bukaNkulunkulu.
Noma
ngabe yini okuye yakho iyakudinga ubukhona
bukaNkulunkulu.
Ubukhona bukaNkulunkulu sikhuluma ngomoya
kaNkulunkulu.
Sikhuluma ngamandla kaNkulunkulu empilweni yakho.
Uyasidinga
isandla sikaNkulunkulu phezu kwempilo yakho.
Uchebezwa
khuleka futhi
and said that you will keep me from evil.
Wakhuleka wathi sengathi unganivikele bubini.
That you will keep me from evil.
Ngathi ungangivikele bubini.
You will understand why I say you must walk with God wherever you go.
Yizosisisa ke ukuthi kungani ngithi sifanele sihambe
ngoNkulunkulu. Let the Lord keep me from evil.
Uchebeze uthi ngeNkulunkulu ungivikele bubini.
You remember the Lord's prayer?
Na ukhumbula umkhuleko weNkosi.
Jesus also told us to pray when we pray we must say what we must pray for God to keep us from evil. It is very much important you make this prayer.
Kubalekile ukwenza lomkhuleko.
It is there in the Lord's prayer our Father art in heaven.
Ukhona lapho kubaba wethu
Jesus. Jesus told us that we must pray and say, pray for God to keep us from evil.
Sibu Jesu yasho ukuthi sikhuleke uNkulunkulu asisize asivikele bubini.
Why must we pray for God to keep us from evil?
Kungani?
Because Church of God there is a devil in this world.
Ngoba kunosathane kuleli
lifa. And Satan is reading each and every moment. proof of the child of God.
USathane ke ubheka noma ukuphi umnyakazo womntana kaNkulunkulu.
You must pray for God to protect you from the schemes of Satan.
Ufanele ukukhuleka ukuthi uNkulunkulu akusindise emacebeni kaSathane.
You must pray for God to protect you from all the plans of wickedness.
Ufanele ukukhuleka ukuthi uNkulunkulu akusindise kuwo wonke amacebo
obubi. God must protect you from all the challenges of all the demons and Satan.
uNkulunkulu akuphephise akuvikele kuwo wonke izinkinga zikaSathane namadimoni.
You are attacked by the devil and it seems like you're not winning. Pray for God to protect you from whatever Satan is doing in your life, in your house, in all areas of your life.
Ukhuleke njalo ukuthi uNkulunkulu akuvikele kuko konke izinto uSathane azenzayo empilweni yakho nasekhaya lakho.
Now you understand why you must walk with God.
Manje soyazwisisa kungani fana ukuthi uhambe noNkulunkulu.
Watching each and every move that you do.
Ngoba uSathane ubheke noma ukuthi umnyakazo wenzani.
He is always ready to attack you.
Futhi umile ubheke ukuthi ngeso sonke isikhathi
akusasele. Moves around like a roaring lion.
IBhayibheli ithi uyabhodla
njengegwenyana. He can devour.
Ubheke noma ubani angamlungu.
So God must keep you from evil. He must protect you from all the evil that may come against you.
uNkulunkulu ufanele ukuthi akuvikele kobuphi obunye nobunye obungeza kuwe.
Are you hearing me, Mr. Khangala? Yes. God must protect you from each and every evil that may come against you.
uNkulunkulu ufanele ukuthi akuvikele kobunye nobunye obuphi obuzoza kuwe.
And the last prayer this man said, that I may not cause pain.
Obugcina lendoda iyakhuleka ngithi ikhuleke ukuthi ingaba kubuzwa ubuhlungu.
Oh, that I may not cause pain.
Uthi ngingehlelo ubuhlungu.
Say it loudly and say that I may not cause pain.
Isho kakhulu uthi ngingehlelo ubuhlungu.
You are not saying, say it again.
Isho futhi.
That I may not cause pain.
Really serious, that you may not cause pain. You see, this man Jabez, his name was he who caused pain.
Lendoda ke uJabez igama layo belisho ukuthi uyo wenza ubuhlungu.
And his last prayer was saying that I may not cause pain.
Kodwa umthandazo wakhe ugcina ukuthi ngingenzi ubuhlungu.
People, we must make this prayer into every day of our lives.
Bakwethu fanele siwenze lo mkhuleko emihla yonke ukuphila
kwethu. Because I'm telling you, in your daily life you are causing pain to other people without knowing it.
Kwesinye isikhathi empilweni yakho wenza ubuhlungu emuntwini ongaboni.
Jabez knew that for all these blessings of God to be upon him.
UJabez bekazi ukuthi lezi bususo zikaNkulunkulu ukuthi zibe kuye.
For God to answer his prayer.
Bekazi ukuthi uNkulunkulu ukuthi aphendule emkhuleko yakhe.
He must make sure that he walks in a righteous path.
Bekufanele ukuthi ahambe endleleni engcwele.
He had to make sure that he does not cause anyone to stumble.
Bekazi ukuthi fanele ukuthi angenze omunye
aye. He had to make sure that he does not cause pain in anyone.
Bekazi ukwenza sure ukuthi angenze omunye
umuntu. God, I pray to you.
Wathi uNkulunkulu ngiyakhuleka kuwe.
Please make me to be a person who does not cause pain to anyone.
Wathi ngicela ukuthi ungenze ngibe umuntu ongenza ubuhlungu nanoma ubani.
Even though my name depicts me as one who causes pain to
noma ngabe igama lami lithi yimi engenza ubuhlungu.
God, I don't want to cause any pain to anyone.
Angifuni ukwenza ubuhlungu nakomunye.
People, you must pray that God must make you not to cause pain to your neighbor.
Sifanele sikhuleke ukuthi uNkulunkulu asize singenze ubuhlungu komakhelwane
bethu. People, you don't even know this, you are making others to cry.
Bantu kusikhathi awazi nokwazi wenza abantu ukuthi bakhale.
Some of you are making others to backslide.
Abanye benu nenza abanye ukuthi babuyele emuva
eNkulunkulu. Others, you are making others to divorce.
Abanye nenza ukuthi abanye behlukane
namakhosikazi. Others, you want to come to school because of you are a bully.
Abanye nibenza ukuthi bangeze esikolweni ngamabhuli.
Others, when they meet the street they turn and then they go in another direction.
Abanye mababona uza estrateni bayajika
bangale ngendlela. Some people even look at you in your eyes.
Abanye basaba nokubheka emehlweni wakho.
Because you are a person who causes pain to others.
Ngoba ngaso sonke isikhathi ubazwisa ubuhlungu.
You are a home destroyer, a home wrecker.
Wena kahle kahle ukudiliza imizi.
You are a liar.
Umkhamba manga.
You are a deceiver.
Uyakhohlisa.
You manipulate people.
Udlala ngabantu.
What's your problem?
Yini inkinga yakho?
Pray for God and say, God, make me not to cause pain.